Painting a vintage dressing table with Annie Sloan chalk paint, nothing could be easier. Annie says that her paint is a girl's paint because there's no sanding, priming, or stripping, unless, of course, within the confines of your own bedroom. What that means is that you can start painting without all the fuss and the mess. Annie's paint currently comes in 24 beautiful colors, ranging from the perfect white to the vibrant Antibes green. By mixing two or more of the colors together, the array becomes limitless. We're going to start by mixing 2/3 cup of the color Provence with 1 to 1.5 teaspoons of the color Olive. Adjust the hue, a fancy word for color, to make a blue-green. Now with a quality bristle brush, big enough to get the job done, paint over the entire piece. On any indents or carved areas, use a stippling motion to get into the grooves. Painting in all directions will give your piece texture and help hide the imperfections. The first coat goes on, the character of the piece starts to appear. The imperfections can be made into virtues in the antiquing phase of the project. You may want to use a roller on the large flat areas. Just add a bit of water to the paint to make it easy to roll. I like to paint the inside of the drawers with an unexpected color to add the element of surprise. After giving the piece sufficient time to dry, paint on the second coat. By dragging over the piece with a brush almost flat to the surface, you can skip over some areas, giving the piece even more texture. I like to have two waxing brushes, one for clear wax and the other for colored wax. The color wax never really seems to come out of the brush completely. First, apply the clear wax. It will seal and add a protective layer to the piece. The wax brush also makes getting into the intricate carved areas a little easier. Wipe away all excess wax to avoid any buildup. Allow the wax to dry completely, about an hour, before you begin the next step. Taking a piece of 100 grit sandpaper, we are going to begin the distressing. This process adds a bit of believable age to any piece, new or old. Sand down the areas that would most normally be bumped and bruised in daily life. By sanding after the clear wax has been applied, the paint has more of a worn appearance rather than sanded. Rub gently at first so you can gauge how much pressure you need to apply. Gilding waxes can be used to add a bit of sparkle to any piece. You can mix the waxes together to get a number of metallic shades. Now select an area you would like to highlight, and using a brush or clean fingers, run the wax over the desired areas. If you get some in an area you don't want, you can clean it using a bit of clear wax. The most unique quality of chalk paint is that it can be mixed with wax to make a colored wax. On a small palette, place clear wax, dark wax, and a bit of olive. Mix together a little at a time. Make sure the wax is blended subtly so that it doesn't appear too spotty. Mix a batch at a time so that the color will vary throughout, applying colored wax to the entire piece. Then, taking a small brush, apply dark wax in the crevices and on the edges of the drawers. Okay, you're almost finished. When the wax is dried, take a piece of cheesecloth or buffing brush and buff out the piece to the desired sheen level. Okay, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Happy painting! Les étoiles, dites-moi une étoile, pourquoi je vous regarde. Music by Melody Gardot.